Thank you. Bye. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. You know, coming back here to Uzhgorod and to this amazing gallery, it's fantastic. I mean, this would be a great experience in New York, let alone this small Ukrainian town on the border of Hungary. The people are wonderful, the people are very sincere. Very heartfelt. There's great art. The music felt great with Joe tonight. It was a wonderful experience. It's great to be back here. Very, very great to be back here. Joe is a great musician. He's a very quick learner. This is not the typical type of thing, typical music that Joe is used to playing. But he has adapted very quickly. And part of the strength of his playing this music is his sound. It's his beautiful sound that is very conducive to my melodies, you know. And he has learned my tunes. And really, you know, communicated as well as anyone possibly could, not only through the harmony, and not only melodically, But I would say spiritually, just the feeling inside the note, I think is very conducive. And there's a vibe, there's a good vibe. There's no condemnation. There's no condemnation. So that's a very good thing. By condemnation, I mean judgment. You know, if things aren't perfect, so what? Life isn't perfect, and jazz isn't perfect. If I hear a group that plays perfect jazz, I'm bored to death, because part of the skill of playing jazz is when you play jazz, you take chances, and it's not always going to turn out perfect. So part of the art of playing jazz is learning to regroup as seamlessly as possible. That's very important. Very, very important. Miles did this all the time. Yeah, in this performance in Uzhgorod at the gallery, all the compositions were mine. I had written. I'm writing all the music. That's all I'm interested in playing, is my own music, you know, as opposed to someone else's original. I want to play my original music. So I've played standards and other people's music for years, and just I want to play my own music now. That's all I'm interested in playing. Although I enjoy hearing other people's music, I love listening to other people's compositions. It's just that when I go to perform and when I go to create, I want to deal with my harmony and my melodies. It's important to me. Doesn't mean it's better than anyone else's. It's just what I prefer to do. That's all.
It's been a really fun and challenging but learning experience playing on this tour with David. His music is very challenging harmonically and formally. And the duo setting is very exposed, but I feel like it's gone very well. We play together rhythmically very well from the very beginning. And I've really enjoyed the experience of this tour and playing in his different configurations of his bands.
And you mentioned the rhythm, Joe. The time is the most important thing, isn't it?
Yeah.
And so if we have that agreement, it just makes everything else, we're able to take chances, right?
Yeah, because things can easily fall apart with two people, but they haven't at all. It's always felt very strong. I had a master teacher named Jerry Bergonzi, and he said that melody trumps harmony, but rhythm is king. And so that kind of goes along with what David would say. Two people should seem like it'd be easier to coordinate, but in a lot of ways it's actually much more difficult.
It's a very transparent situation, you know. It's very open. Communication, we both got to be at the top of our game. We have no third person to trust or depend upon.
Yeah, this is my first time in Ukraine. Unfortunately, I won't see much of it, but this gallery is really amazing. The sound in here is great, very professional. Audio and video recording taking place here today. I look forward to hearing and seeing that, and hopefully be able to come back to Ukraine sooner than later and see even more of the city and more of the country.